been a massive series of MasterChef. And last night, Diana and Ben battled it out to be crowned winner of the 9th season. Have a look.
You are Australia's MasterChef for 2017.
That means you've won $250,000. You get a monthly column in Australia's leading premium food magazine, Delicious. And most importantly, you've won the title of Australia's MasterChef.
Diana, there's only one thing left to do. Are you ready?
Yes, George.
Come and get
moment. Diana Chan, that is a name you'll be hearing a lot of in the coming weeks and months and years ahead. The winner of MasterChef Australia 2017 joins us from Melbourne. Diana, we had Carly on the show yesterday and she picked this. She said that you were going to be the champion. You must be feeling over the moon. How have the last 24 hours been for you?
Oh my God, the last 24 hours have been absolutely crazy. It's been I've been overwhelmed by the amazing support and love that I've received, and it's been crazy, but I'm so happy.
Aww. I tell you, Diana, what is crazy, that dessert that you had to do.
Oh, my God.
The fruit. Why not just eat normal fruit?
But how, not MasterChef-y enough.
No, I know. But how were you so focused? 6 hours that took you to do.
Oh my goodness, that was an insane cook. And you know, I think both of us, Ben and myself, did incredibly well. You know, it was all about precision and just, and there was so much into it. Like 6 hours of cooking was crazy under that pressure.
Oh my God, he got the liquid centres. What happened with the liquid centres? It just blew my mind. I was feeling for you so much with every little cut to try to get that gel coming out. I mean, that must have been heartbreaking when you realised you had to go back and start again, and then it still didn't work, and then...
Yeah. I think I wasted a lot of time doing that the second time round, but, you know, you gotta give it a go. If it doesn't work once, you kind of have to give it another try, and then if it didn't work the second time, I knew that,
Well, you always kept your calm. That was the thing about it. Now, you've won $250,000. You have a magazine column. What do you plan to do next, Diana?
Oh, look, I've been inundated with amazing opportunities in the past few weeks, and I think for me now I'm going to take some time out, go sit on a beach somewhere, have a cocktail and relax, and then, you know, I've always wanted to do my food concept, so I think now it's becoming a reality, you know, a fresh casual restaurant that serves wholesome food with fusion flavours. Yeah, and another opportunity that I'm working on is to boost tourism in Malaysia, in my home country, and maybe a food and travel show. But, you know, watch this space. Lots of exciting things coming.
Right? So even though you and Ben were competing last night, you know, obviously, you seem so close. Is that the same with all the contestants?
Absolutely. All 24 contestants. You know, it's crazy because we're all from different dynamics and we all have different backgrounds. And you know, you put 24 people together, it's like school camp. It's pretty random, but you know, all of us got along really well. And it was like, I think it's because, you know, you're sort of cut off from the outside world, and we're each other's support in the house, to be honest.
And what sort of, what does that do then? Because there was one point between you two last night. It came down to the wire. For you to have that victory over Ben, did you kind of turn to him and sort of say, sorry, but I'm so happy for me?
Oh, you know what? You know, either one of us, it was so close. It could have been him, it could have been me, you know. I mean, yeah, but it's one of those things, like, it's a competition at the end of the day.
Yeah.
And there was always going to be a winner, and there was always going to be someone that came second. But, you know, he was such a formidable opponent. And
we're just seeing this now. This was a beautiful moment when, you know, you'd both sort of hit the wall, and he's come and just ducked down and put his arm around you. And it was so emblematic of that incredible supportive environment that MasterChef has. And I think I speak for the whole country when I say that really just makes me sick. When I watch a reality TV show, I want to see knives out. I want to see people stabbed in the back, bitching about each other every time the cameras turn. I mean,
I think that's Yummy Mummies.
That's right. Oh, maybe I'm sorry. I'm thinking of Survivor. That was my mistake. Do you have it? What would you say to the next generation of MasterChefs, the ones who might be going into the kitchen next year? What's the secret weapon?
Well, I think the secret weapon for me was one, to stay calm, because it definitely helps when you're working under pressure, and it's probably easier said than done. But I think sleep. Yeah, that was my best friend in the house. When I'm not, you know, cooking or reading on like recipes, I go to bed and I just rest, because the days are long. It's, you know, 12-hour days on average, and it is very draining. And get lots of rest because you'll need it.
12-hour days, that's almost as long as this show.
Diana, you go and enjoy those cocktails on the beach somewhere. We can't wait to see what you do next. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much, guys.